So I'm going to set my... Wait, what? Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. My name is Anousha and today we're going to try out a lot of new products I bought. I also got a lot of them for my birthday and I'm so excited to try all these new stuff. So let's just get started. So the first thing I'm going to try out is the Farsali Rose Gold Elixir. And this one I got for my birthday. I'm so excited for this one. Like, oh, how pretty. Okay. Okay, I think this is way too much. Oh, okay, yeah, no. I think I applied way too much. Ooh. So if you have dry skin, you're going to love this. It's so moisturizing. It's a little bit, it has like an oil feeling color to your skin. Here in the Netherlands, I don't know what it is with this summer, but it's like one day raining and one other day there it's like really nice weather, so today is like one of those gray raining day, so that's why I got my sweater on, feeling cozy. So I already did my eyebrows with the Makeup Revolution one. Now I'm going to do my eyeshadow. So for the lid primer I got the samples from Smashbox. This is their new photo finish lip primer. I got a light one and a medium one. So today I'm going to use the light one. Really like this. It's like a little bit thicker than a concealer. It has like a little bit of a silicone feeling to it, but not too much. Like, it's not a silicone paste. It's also not a concealer, so yeah, I really like this. So I'm going to set my base with the Catrice Nude Illusion Loose Powder. Now moving on to eyeshadow. So for eyeshadow, I'm going to use the Yes Please palette from ColourPop. This is what the palette looks like. These are like my colors. I really love warm shades. So I have not an idea what I'm going to do today, but let's just get started. I think I'm going to do like a pink look. Yeah. So for the first shade, I'm going to use the color Big Cocktails. This is the one here. This will be my transition color. These shadows are so pigmented. Look at this. Slightly smaller blending brush. And I'm going to take the shade Champs. This one here. Left side, there's like, for now, there's not a lot of fallout. Okay, so the next shade I'm going to take is this one right here, and it's called a butter cake. Really love these names. Butter cake. I'm just placing it on the side and a little bit underneath the first color. So right here. So now I'm taking Mischief, the one right here, to darken it up. The same brush. This one I'm going to apply over here. So I like to really dark up. It's So I'm going to take the same base again. Apply it on the center of my eyelid. Okay, that's way too much. And now I'm going to take GNO. Gino? GNO? I don't know how you pronounce it, but this one right here. I'm with the same brush. Just applying it on the center. So I will finish off my eyes later on. So let's move on to the face. I got the Herborian CC cream. So this is not a foundation, but a like a BB cream. But this one is more for even out your skin. So I don't know if you heard about this, but this is a face cream that will change to your skin color. So it's just a white cream, and then when you rub it in, then it will be your skin color. So let's try it out. I'm so excited to try this. So I bought this at the Sephora because my boyfriend took me there for my birthday in Germany. Look at how white. Okay, I'm so scared. I just have to rub this in like a normal moisturizer. I have the feeling it's a little ashy on me. Like, it's just give me a white case. It does feel really smooth, but like it hasn't done anything for my imperfection or anything. Not more than another foundation I can use, but I have used this all summer, is the Liquid Skin from Kiko, and this is in the color Neutral 145. It's a little warm for me, but I have mixed this with my Maybelline Fit Me to make it lighter, and I really really love this foundation. Like, it's just a light coverage, I would say. Not this. And I got also the W7 Power Puff, and I already read it, so let's see how this will work. So I normally apply this with a brush because I feel you get the most coverage then out of it if you want to have coverage. Okay, I have to do this absorbs everything. So I think I have to apply one more layer. It's a little hard, like it feels really squishy, but the round part feels really hard on my skin. You can even hear it. Do you hear it? You hear it bouncing on my face. For my concealer, the newest one I have is the Tarte Tape Shape. I used this one time, I think. And I have the color 10 Sand. It's a little light for me now, but I think in the winter time this color will be perfect. So, just go, because I know you don't need a lot. And I'm just going to highlight with my Maybelline Fit Me concealer. And then let's try out the other side. Like, what's happening right here? Into the sockets. It's really strange. See that? Right here. Whoa, that's freaky. I have never had it happen to me before. And let me try with a brush, but I do not like this side. Then this side is better, but it's a little hard on my skin. So like, it really blends out nicely, but I don't think I will use this one again. It's not worth it. Okay, so I'm just going to take a brush apply some concealer again. Like, come on, this, look at the difference. Bam. Okay, yeah, it was definitely the sponge. So to set my base with the Catrice Loose Powder. And this is transparent matte. I don't usually like matte powders because I have dry skin. I heard so many good things about this. So I had to try. Okay, so moving on to contour. I got the Shade Light palette from Kat Von D. And I'm so excited to try this. I heard so many good things about this. So, well, you all know what it looks like. So, I think I'm going to use the middle shade. This one right here. I'm just going to take my fan brush. Oh, wow. Okay. Maybe I can even use the light shade. Like, whoa. Oh, this blends out really good. It's like, oh, it's really pigmented. It blends out really nice. It's not muddy on the face. Okay, I really like this. Wow. Okay, I'm really impressed. I think I like this more than the Anastasia one. Okay, so I changed up my routine. So I changed up a little bit of my routine. And I will tell you when I'm going why. So first, what I'm now going to do is highlighting. The reason why is because I've always seen trouble. Like when I apply highlighter, it is just like a stripe. And I do not like that. I love it when it's like blended into your skin. And I had a hard time with that. So that's why I first going to use highlighter. And I'm going to use the ColourPop Give Me More. And this is what it looks like. I'm going to use this shade. It's called Extra. We love being extra, you know. So I'm going to take that one. Looks like really golden when you apply it. In the pen it looks pink. When you apply it, it's like... And then for bronzer, I'm going to take the Maybelline Terre Indiens Brick Bronzer. I am so bad at pronouncing names, but I think you already noticed it. I have the color 2 for brunette. Yeah, they didn't have another shade, only one. Yeah, definitely not going to work. What I just tried this out. Oh, yeah, I only swatched this. And the you can use it like this is a matte bronzer, so you can use only the matte one, but you can also mix it to give it a little bit of shimmer. But if you want like a natural highlighter, this is so gorgeous. Yeah, I don't think you can see it, but it's so pretty. But now, because I already applied my highlighter, like you can now really blend this all out. Going to finish off the eyes and birthday cake mixed together. From inner corner, I'm these two, GNO and Spoiled. I also have new lashes. I got the Anitude lashes. Some mascara first. Just going to use my L'Oreal telescopic one. Let's finish off the lips. I had like a few new products. So this one I tested out in my last video from Steltone. If you haven't seen yet, I will leave it down below. And I also got the, what is it? From I Love Makeup Melted Chocolate Lipstick. So I already tried these both out, but these are the really new products I have. Better. So, okay, it's already really disgusting, sorry. Good, yeah, good choice. This is a liquid lipstick, it's not going to dry down. but it feels really smooth on my lips. I have to say, when you go get something to eat or drink, it's not going to last long. But yeah, I really like this. It's not drying at all. And so to finish it off, I'm going to use the Milani Make It Dewy. And I also don't know about this. Like, it makes your skin like really really dewy. And I heard that the Make It Less from Milani is better. So I also want to try that one out. So you can see, look how dewy I look. Like, my god. Okay. Yeah. Okay, so a breakdown from all the products. So the products I did not like was the Power Puff from W7. I have to say, it blended out my foundation okay, but my concealer, you saw what was happening, it was really strange. I also not big fan of the Catrice loose powder. It also maybe because I have dry skin. Oh guys, let me take another picture and see. I'm just going to take off the line. Okay, I look like really really dewy, but you can see a little bit of flashback. It's not much, but you can see right here and on my chin. So this completes the videos, guys. I hope you really enjoyed it. If so, please give it some thumbs up. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel. And I have a few ideas for my next video. I thought about making a full face of Milani products, because Milani is my favorite drugstore products, but I know they have some hits and misses. So, or I got a new hack from Wayne Goss I really want to try out. So what are you more curious about? Let me know down in the comments, and I will see you next Wednesday. Thank you so much for watching. Bye bye.